الله أكبر، الله أكبر.
My name is Ahmed Naeem and I'll be your chairman for the evening. What we've come to listen to tonight is Mr. Ahmed Didat. What he'll be speaking upon is a book written by the Pope. Now in this book, he deals with various religions, and amongst one of the religions he deals with is Islam. Now in the book, he devotes approximately 4 pages to Islam, and it is those 4 pages that Mr. Didat would reply to tonight. So without keeping you further, I would call Mr. Didat to speak to you tonight. Thank you.
الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده اللهم يا مفتح الأبواب ويا مسبب الأسباب ويا دليل الحائرين توكلت عليك يا رب العالمين وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد. Mr. Chairman and my dear brothers and sisters, the topic has been well advertised. The topic is Islam's answer to the Pope's pious pronouncements. I'm sure all of you must have seen this by now. Islam's answer to the Pope's pious pronouncements. An amazing thing, this morning I went to Maritzburg and got the Maritzburg newspaper called the Natal Witness. We had also supplied them with the advert. This advert appeared in the Sunday Tribune, in the Daily News, in the Natal Mercury, in the Leader, in the Post, as is. But the Witness, the Natal Witness in Maritzburg, they have changed the title. The advert appears. But they put it, Islam's answer to the Pope's pronouncements. The word pious is taken out. Pious is eliminated. And they give us a reason. That the ASA, there is a body called the Advertising Standards Authority. ASA. They send us a fax telling us, in reference to this advert, it says here, the word of the use, pious, in this particular context, may be seen to be disparaging. This word, pious, may be seen to be disparaging in terms of Clause 6, Section 2 of the Code of Advertising Practice. So if you take the word pious out, then they will allow the advert. Otherwise, the advert is rejected. What makes me to consider him pious? You see, in the Holy Quran, in Surah Maryam, chapter 19 of the Holy Quran, Allah Bari Ta'ala says, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا, and they say that Ar-Rahman, the merciful God, has begotten a son. They say, who say? The Christians. They say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has begotten a son. In answer to that, Allah says, لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْءٍ إِدَّا. It's one of the most abominable assertions. The worst swearing that you can give Allah is this. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَتَّرْنَا مِنْهُ. At it, the skies are ready to burst. وَتَنْشَقَّ الْأَرْضُ. And the earth to split asunder. وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ حَدَّا. And the mountains to fall down in utter ruin. أَنْدَ أَوْلِ الرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدَا. That they should say that Ar-Rahman, the merciful God, has begotten his son. Allah reacts very strongly. The worst swearing I can give any of you is to call you a bastard. This word bastard, people get shocked. It is from the Holy Bible. The King James Version has this word bastard 3 times in this Bible. 3 times, the word bastard. So look, this is biblical. This is not an offensive word anymore. It's in the Holy Bible. The worst swing I can give anybody is to call you a bastard, insinuating that your mother had committed zina, adultery. That's the strongest. Worst swing I can give anybody is to call him that. Allah says the worst swing you can give me, him, is to say that he has begotten a son. Because begetting is an animal act. It belongs to the lower animal functions of sex. How can you attribute such a quality to God, that God begot a son, somebody else's wife, Joseph the carpenter's wife, he goes and have sex with her and beget a bastard child? MashaAllah, may Allah forgive. So he reacts very strongly. Now, His Holiness the Pope, you see, in this book of his, Crossing the Threshold of Hope, he is giving biblical quotation in this 200 and some 20 pages. He has quoted the Bible 209 times. In this book, little book, 209 times he's quoted the Holy Bible. Verses. And one verse, he quotes it eight times the same verse. Amazing. No other verse. That one verse he quoted eight times. And that is the Gospel of St. John, chapter 3, verse 16. John 3:16 is a famous verse among the Christians. No Christian can do missionary work without memorizing this. That God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him might have eternal life and shall not perish. The only begotten son. God has got, according to the Bible, many sons. He's got sons by the tons in the Bible. But he said, no, Jesus is not like that. Jesus is the only begotten son, begotten, not made. Not like Adam. Adam was made by God. Every dog, pig and donkey was made by God. Not like that. This is begotten, not made. Means yet sexed and produced. Begetting means sexed and produced. So Allah reacts. And His Holiness the Pope, eight times in his book, the same chapter, John 3:16, he quotes, and every time he quotes, he takes the word begotten out. Shouldn't we applaud him? Please, give it a clap. So if I call him this a pious thing, he's heeding the warning of the Quran. He has heeded. So in my Quran Speaks in the Sunday Tribune, I quote this Quranic ayah. Every week, if you people are reading it, I don't know whether I'm just throwing it away. You people, I don't know whether you benefit from it. The Quran speaks. Every Sunday, there's a quotation from the Holy Quran with commentary. So I quoted this ayah a couple of months ago. So, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا لَكَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا. That's all. So those who say that Allah has begotten a son, this is one of the most monstrous thing for anybody to do. Most abominable thing for anybody to do. To say that Allah begot a son. And in my notes, I said, you see, His Holiness the Pope, he has heeded the warning of the Quran. Don't talk like that. Allah says, don't talk like that. You're swearing me. You see, you young people, you come along, you want to argue and debate with me. Now, young people, don't have a little brushing. I don't mind. I enjoy it. And you irritate me. I'm an old man, 77. Maybe I didn't have a good night's sleep. Maybe I had taken some medicine, some pills. And you irritate me. So what I say, go, man, you're a bloody fool. You're a fool. What do? You laugh. No, I'm sure you laugh. You won't punch me on the jaw. For calling you a fool. And you irritate me further. I say, go, man. You are a bloody ox. You know ox? I say, go, man. You are a bloody monkey. I say, you are a bloody donkey. What you do? You laugh. I say, the old man is tired now, man. I'm rubbing him the wrong way around. But if I take your mother's name, no laughter. Say, uncle, not one more word. I'm going to lose all the respect I have for you. Already it's gone. If once I touch your mother's name, there's no more respect. But you say, the shot of punching me on the jaw, you say, look, I'm going to lose all the respect I have for you. Don't take my mother's name. Don't take my wife's name. Don't take my daughter's name. Call me what you like. Call me monkey. Call me donkey. Call me a fool, call me what you like, but don't take my mother's name. Am I right? This is how Allah reacts. That the worst swearing they can give me is this. And His Holiness the Pope has heeded the warning and he has expunged it 8 times out of 8. 8 out of 8 times. Not even by mistake the word begotten got in. Inadvertently, it didn't get in. So I take off my hat to the Pope, and if he was here, I'd kiss his hand. And I'll encourage everybody, when he comes in September, kiss his hand. That guy deserves that you kiss his hands. But if you want to go and kiss his hand, he'll kick you in the face. I mean, this man is a master psychologist. Look, he's using psychology. He's catching fish. He'll kick you in the face. This is how he puts it. For example, I show you. Were you all given this pamphlet? You're supposed to be given tonight. Everybody was supposed to have this pamphlet. What happened? The Pope says, this pamphlet, the whole chapter from this book is reproduced. And this was supposed to be given out to each and everyone here tonight. Nobody has received it. Stop. I think we were very busy. My brother Kasim, who has been in charge of this, we were whole day in Marisburg in the Supreme Court, waiting for the Master of the Supreme Court to behead us all. I left at 4 o'clock to go home and charge my batteries for this. And they just finished 6 o'clock and they came now. So please forgive them. If you have the time, pick it up from the IPC. The whole chapter on Islam, on the life of Muhammad, is in this book. We reproduced it here. And this was, I was supposed to give it to you more like a text to say, now let's see on the front page, what does it say? It says, he says, I'm quoting the Pope again, some of the most beautiful names in the human language are given to the God of the Quran. Some of the most beautiful names in the human language are given to the God of the Quran. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I had touched this on the 26th of July, here in this hall. How many of you were present? Please put up your hand, those of you who were present. Just put up high that I can see. No, it bears repeating, it bears repeating. See, if all of you were here, then I says, no, let's carry on from there. But bulk of you I can see, you were not here. So he says, some of the most beautiful names in the human language are given to the God of the Quran. Most probably somebody told him. Or probably he read the Quran. Because in the Holy Quran, Allah says, Allah says, Huwa Allahu allazi la ilaha illahu. He is Allah besides whom there is no other God. Al-Malik, the King. Al-Quddus, the Holy One. As-Salam, the source of peace and perfection. Al-Mu'min, the guardian of faith. Al-Muhaymin, the preserver of safety. Al-Aziz, the exalted in might. Al-Jabbar, the irresistible. Al-Mutakabbir, the supreme. Subhanallah, amma yushrikun. Glory to Allah. He is free from the things that they attribute to Him. Hu Allah, He is Allah. Al-Khaliq, the creator. Al-Bari, the evolver. Al-Muthawwir, the bestower of forms and colors. Lahul Asmaul Husna. These are the most beautiful names. Allah says that. And the Pope reproduces that. Some of the most beautiful names in the human language are given to the God of the Quran. There's nothing like that in His Bible. There's nothing like that in the Bhagavad Gita or the Ramayana. There's no other religious scripture on earth which has this type of attributes given to God Almighty. And the Pope says that, coming from the mouth of the enemy, he says that these are the most beautiful names in the human language are given to the God of the Quran, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.